Hey guys, Thatnub here. Last year we started doing a huge push on our long-term food storage. We already had some, but we could see the food prices are going to start going up because of all the instability in the world. It didn't take long for us to run out of room in the house for all these 5-gallon buckets, plus we were still adding more every week. Now your food preps need to be kept in a cool, dark place, so I started looking into adding a walk-in cooler to the house. Turns out those things are expensive. But I found you can build something for a few thousand bucks that'll work pretty well. All you need is a shed, some insulation, an air conditioner, and something called a Coolbot, which tricks your air conditioner into running colder. Last September, we bought a Yardline Waverly 8x12-foot shed from Costco for about $2,000 installed. We could have got something a little bit cheaper, but I'm not a super cool construction guy, and I wanted it to A, actually get built, and to not fall over from the light breeze. Add some insulation and plywood for the inside walls and an air conditioner, and we're up to about $2,700, which leaves just enough in the budget for one of those cool bots. Now, because not too many people were working and supplies were low, we couldn't get it installed until the beginning of November. I moved one of the security cameras so we could watch the installer build this thing. This guy knew what he was doing and had it up in a couple hours. I wanted the floor to be insulated as well, so he let me get in his way for a little bit before he finished the floor to do that. We also added a little bit more support under the shed than what was required because we're going to be adding a lot of weight once this thing was finished. So now it was up, but I was still crazy busy at work, so I had to wait a few months before I can start insulating the inside of the shed. I wanted it to be over-insulated, so we put a layer of Pink Panther insulation down first, then 3-inch foam board, then staggered another 2-inch foam board over that. For a wall, I just placed up some plywood. It doesn't look pretty on the inside, but it does work. Once all that was done, I realized that it was going to be pretty dark in there, so I bought a solar-powered motion-activated floodlight and set it up in the middle of the room. Then I added a window unit air conditioner, and for now, we're done. I haven't gotten the Coolbot yet because the room stays around 60 degrees, and for now, that's good enough. When we get into August or September and the temps get real high, we'll reevaluate the need for that. For now, it's time to start getting all those buckets out of the house. The last thing I did was buy this remote temperature sensor so I can see how cold it was inside our cooler without actually opening the door. So on this display, the outdoor temperature is actually the inside temperature, and the indoor temperature is the outside temperature. And you can see it's keeping the inside under 65 degrees, which is perfect for our food storage. Well, that's all I have for this video. Bang around that bell icon if you want to be notified when new videos come out. Call us on the hotline if you have comments or questions and want to be featured in an upcoming video. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, check us out on the website, and we'll see you guys on the next one.